Hi everyone, I'm Ashley Novak and this is Peddi-TV. The steel industry is on an upward trend in 2018. In this episode, you'll learn about unique projects from our friends at Sukup Manufacturing, the PeddiBot-1200 Triangulation Scanning System, and you'll even get to enjoy a one-of-a-kind Lyle Menke Peddi-TV blooper reel. Sukup Manufacturing is one of the largest grain bin manufacturers in the world, but they don't just build the biggest, they also build the smallest. Watch as Steve Sukup and Emily Schmidt tell us about one of their most notable products, safety homes, structures designed to help people in need.
Hello, I'm Sean Zeilingen. I'm here with Sukup Manufacturing, Steve and Emily. And today they're going to talk to us about their safety homes. Tell me, what is Sukup Manufacturing specializing in?
Well, our main products are the grain drying and storage. The grain bins you see out through the countryside. I think on your way over from Bradley, you probably saw a good number of grain bins. We actually hit that hard the year 2000. So we just put up two million bushel bins here in Iowa, and a lot of the structural steel, our roofs on those are 100,000 K roofs on there, and it came off the Peddinghaus saw and drill lines to give us that strongest bin in the industry.
Emily, what is the Sukup Safety Home?
The Sukup Safety Home is an 18-foot diameter grain bin that's been converted such that it can be used as a home. It's two rings tall and has a double roof on the top for being able to decrease the temperature inside the home. It's been used all over the world for relief efforts, and now it's been used for communities and homes after many different natural disasters.
One day with six people can have a safety home up and bolted in with the door on.
So they do come with hand tools if it's ordered by a nonprofit, but many times when someone goes down and builds them, they bring the normal electric drills and things like that, but it's also, they can do a blitz build and get 10 homes up in 1 week.
You guys are making IKEA jealous.
Yeah, much easier to assemble.
Yeah, exactly. What major event led to the creation of the Sukup Safety Home?
Back in January 2010, there was a huge earthquake that hit Haiti, and it just demolished all the structures. Although you see structures down there of concrete, it's not the same level of concrete that we have here. And so many of them just crumbled after the earthquake. And our safety director, Brett Nelson, had bin homes on his mind because he was thinking about building a bin home for himself that fall.
And I said, well, let's keep it to a common size. So that's how we came up with 18 foot. During the last hurricane, they actually put up to 60 people in one of those homes and let the 140 mile an hour winds beat on it for 8 hours, and everybody came out safe. So it saved lives with everything.
Globally, where have you guys installed the safety home?
We have 270 in Haiti, and then we have 20 in Peru, 10 in Kenya, and then the latest effort is for a refugee camp for parentless children in Uganda.
And people keep spreading. Had a cousin email me the other day, and he was going to Guatemala and was just wondering whether that would be a fit for him there on a mission trip. And so it's one that the word is spreading.
You've seen the PeddiBot-1200 at FabTech, and you will see it at the NASCC, but watch as our experts dig deeper into the triangulation scanning system of this robotic thermal technology.
What's going on, everybody? I'm Sean Zeilingen, and I'm here today with Elliot Bass, our regional sales manager, and we're gonna talk about this machine we got behind us. So Elliot, tell me, what are we standing in front of?
We are standing in front of the PeddiBot-1200. It is a robotic thermal processing machine. It uses a 400 amp plasma with a small torch design and a more conical nozzle. Allows us to get into some areas better and do some things with less rework. The 400 amp also allows us to do weld prep on 2-inch flanges.
I know that a problem with a lot of fabricators and their CNC machinery is probing, constantly having to touch the material and figure out where it's at. How does this machine fix that issue?
We managed to eliminate probing by integrating laser scanning. So once the part is indexed into the machine, we take a pass over the profile, which gives us all of the information we need to know about the full cutting window. And within that window, you get web placement, flange deviation, to both create better cut paths as well as avoid any collision.
A big factor in a lot of shops is accuracy and things like that. How does that triangulation scanning system kind of solve that issue?
By scanning the profile in lieu of touch probing, we're not making any guesses by trying to speed the production through the machine. So the torch path is more accurate. The torch height, which is critical when doing any kind of weld preps, is critical. All of that is figured into the programming and actual motion of the robot itself throughout cutting. More accurate parts, less rework, overall better throughput because of that.
Elliot, this machine itself has a triangulation scan that helps accurately run the processing area. What other scans are involved in the PeddiBot?
There's a torch-mounted laser that would scan the lead edge of the profile, and it works in conjunction with the trail edge measurement to verify profile length as well as on-the-fly measurement for the X-axis.
Where would this machine fit in an existing Peddinghaus production line?
The PeddiBot would ideally be placed in a system that already has a drill saw. So you're feeding that with the drill saw, you're getting your copes on it, you're getting your layout with it, and it's also there as an auxiliary line if your production demand increases.
It's the end of an era here at Peddinghaus. The original founder of Peddi-TV himself, Mr. Lyle Menke, is officially passing the torch. We have highlighted some of his best moments in this blooper reel.
So we will start in 5, 4, 3, 2.
Hi, this is Lyle Menke. Wait.
Hey, I'm on camera. Yes, I am. Shed's right here. No, he's back here. We're filming. I gotta go. What do you need?
Are you rolling? I see a red light on.
That's a blooper.
I'm getting more animated as I get into it here.
Read Berkeley.
I went brain dead.
We're also looking.
Wait a minute. Just lost my train of thought.
Law gave.
Nah, crap.
We're going to talk today about the Peddi. Hi, this is Lyle Menke for Peddi-TV. Wait, let's start again.
Oh, by the way, with all this video footage, there's sure to be a few bloopers, so watch for those. It's Vegas, baby. What happens in the booth stays in the booth.
Dorothy, can you tell us a little bit about yourself? What's that line again?
All right.
Okay. Bye-bye.
What's a good French term, like sac bleu? How do you pronounce that?
Are we rolling right now, Sean?
Yep. Yep. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, why not?
Hello?
I'm Lyle. Lyle, you who?
Lyle.
You.
You-hoo!
I should go step down. So now we look at one to one.
I need a machine. Now all I need is a machine.
Light, let's go. I
what?
Hope.
Wait.
You want to start again?
Wow.
Man, this is a way to travel. Check it out, Light.
Man, this is really great.
See you next time. Yeah, I fumbled a little bit, but that's too bad.
That's all for Peddi-TV. Be sure to visit booth 1808 to get the full Peddinghaus NASCC experience this April 11th to 13th in Baltimore, Maryland. Check out our socials, our website, And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the Peddi News Magazine for free. I'm Ashley Novak. See you next time on Peddi TV.